It started recording in a weird place, but that's alright.
And we have one daily double awaiting you in these categories. A nude awakening.
Oh.
Edgar Allan Poe. Scary words. World capitals. Salmon. And the 20th century. A lot of clues, a lot of categories.
Player one, you're in control.
Take a selection. Bibliophobia. A fear of these might hurt you if you want to continue your studies. Let's hear it. Player two. Use the Wii remote or press the corresponding.
I know how to steer these.
I like that one.
You get to pick again, player two.
Let's go salmon for 1,000.
When it gets its silvery scales and migrates to the sea for the first time, a young salmon is called this.
Young buck.
Yes, player one. That is correct. Player one, you pick again, please. According to an 1833 description, Poe dressed entirely in this color. Let's hear it. Player two.
I got the timing down now.
That's it.
Yeah.
Select again. On Valentine's Day, 1989, the Ayatollah Khomeini showed no love for this author's satanic verses, giving him a death sentence.
Yeah, I got the timing down now. Not gonna be walking all over me anymore.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Weighing up to 100 pounds, this large type of salmon shares its name with a warm, dry wind. Okay, player two.
It's just
pick
a game,
player two.
Yeah, it's just a game. Unless I beat your ass and then you.
World Book says this country leads the world in salmon fishing with more than 450,000 tons caught each year.
I'm guessing that you'd probably go for it.
I'm not going to go for it. Is it Canada?
The United States.
It's not Canada.
The United States is true.
Choose again. Player two.
It's
if you've got dendrophobia, a fear of these, we suggest not climbing any. Player two.
Look at that. I got the timing.
Yes.
Oh, come on.
Player two.
What?
That was bullshit.
This city on the Malay Peninsula is the capital
of
Malaysia.
Come on, what's the capital of Malaysia?
Do you?
We'll find out, I guess.
Here's what we were looking for. Kuala Lumpur.
Oh.
Choose again. Player two. Laid out in 1874, the botanical gardens in this capital have an observatory with a statue of Tycho Brahe.
Oh, yeah.
It's player two.
So you're Denmark.
Player two.
Switzerland.
This world capital is on the island of Java.
Capital in Java.
Player one.
Oh,
sorry,
Manila.
Damn it.
Anyone else want to hazard a guess on this?
Something else.
Let's hear it. Player two.
You meant something else. You very deliberately mouse over and clicked it.
The capital of India is not pronounced Calcutta or Calicut, but this way.
If he says what it is,
okay,
it's gonna
player
be.
Two.
Uh-oh. I still know myself.
Back to you for our Budapest is the capital of Hungary. This is the capital of Romania.
Why
yes,
do you say that Budapest is the capital? It's because it's Bucharest.
Right you are. Select again.
I like how Alex speaks in riddles.
Salmon are members of the same family as the speckled or brook variety of this fish. Player one.
Not so much of a fish.
I grew up in a farm.
You get to pick again.
This wasn't a fish farm, though.
If you suffer from heliophobia, a fear of this, you might be a vampire.
Damn it!
Please pick again, player two. On February 15th, 1965, Canada's new flag, which featured an 11-pointed one of these, flew for the first time. Let's hear it, player two.
I hit it first.
I can hear it. You didn't.
What a punk.
Player two, back to you. On February 8th, 1904, Japanese ships attacked this country's fleet at Lushun, Manchuria, beginning a war.
Manchuria.
Okay, player two. That's correct. We return to you, player two. Elizabeth II succeeded her father, this man, who died unexpectedly at age 56.
I can say Elizabeth the First, but I don't
yes,
think that's
player
right.
One.
Oh, it's George. Oh, damn it.
Nope.
Damn it.
Anyone else here to try to come up with the correct response?
George, I watched the crew.
Okay, player two. Good for you.
Oh, good for you.
Player two.
You
can
Alex
begin, please.
Is happy for
in the 1920s, this fascist leader of Italy set up a puppet regime in Albania and reconquered Libya. It's player two.
The moose.
You got it.
The moose.
Please pick again. Player two. Fish ladders help salmon travel upstream over these man-made obstructions.
We both
let's
messed
hear
up
it.
The
player
timing.
Two.
You sounded more like a witch.
So if you have pluviophobia, the fear of this weather condition, we probably won't find you singing in it. Player one?
And jump the gun.
Oh, please.
What?
You've got 7,600.
Yeah,
I only
again,
now
player
have
one.
1,000. I'm going.
No.
In 1953. He produced the first issue of Playboy for $10,000. Yes, player two. Player two, back to you for our... If you have stygiophobia derived from the river Styx, you have a fear of this, so act right.
It's not even the rivers, is it?
Okay, player one. Yes.
Yes. I like how it's me good feeling stuff.
No buts like, about it.
Yes.
David Caruso, Jimmy Smits, and Dennis Franz all turned the other cheek on this talk show. It's player one. Right. Player one, you pick again, please. Kathleen Turner and Jerry Hall weren't close-minded playing Mrs. Fur in the stage version of The Graduate. Yes, player two.
It's Mrs. Brown. Mrs. Brown.
I already picked it.
You get to pick again, player two. Poe's wife, who passed away at age 24, had this name, like the state at whose university Edgar studied. Let's hear it, player one.
You think that's why he married her?
I think he married her because she was his cousin.
You again, player one. The first obituary of Poe, which spoke of the frailties of genius, appeared in this city's Sun newspaper. Player one?
Why does every city have a Sun
newspaper? Anyone else?
What is it? The bird book, the bird sun that gives
okay,
news people buttons.
There's no moon newspaper.
That's not it.
Oh,
any other checkers?
Well, Amanda's got it.
Yeah. Go, Mandy.
Player three? return to you, player three.
Oh, come on.
Answer, it's the Daily Double.
You girls won't have it all.
You're in last place.
350. I don't want to.
In 1842, I'll review this British author's Barnaby Rudge, which features, a human-like raven.
Idiot.
Here's Charles Dickens. Select again. Trying to escape his teen idol image, this Partridge Family star posed nude for Rolling Stone in 1972. Yes, player one.
And it wasn't even on when I was alive.
We return to you, player one.
Wait, when you're alive?
Number two, shocked viewers at the Armory Show. Let's hear it, player one. That's correct. Here's the $1,000 clue for you. Poe won an 1833 short story contest with a story about one of these found in a bottle. It's player one.
Oh, come on. It's not a manuscript in a bottle.
Could be.
Sting sang about message in a bottle.
I don't think he was talking about Edgar Allan Poe, though, was he?
That's right, way to go.
Holy shit! I want to punch you in your face.
Maybe it's small. Here we go.
Now it's time for correct order. Put the list in the correct order by pressing the corresponding button on the remote. Put these airports in order from fewest to most annual passengers.
Fewest to most.
I just got vaporized.
Look, you got wave.
I'm wavy now. What?
You need to get a t-shirt with the wave on. Or hat.
Player three, you are currently in last place. Clues are worth 400 to 2,000.
Dunked on player three there.
Signs and symbols. Math.
Oh, you're in trouble now.
One world. The comics. And the Bible.
Oh,
the quotation marks on the beat. Let's get back into this now. You have control of the board.
This
E.T. the extraterrestrial was released, grossing more than $300 million that year.
What was the category?
Okay, player one. Oh.
You missed the E.T. president.
Yeah.
Player one, back to you. Here's Kelly from our clue crew. With the clue.
He was president in 1906 when he proclaimed Devil's Tower in Wyoming the first national monument.
Yes, player two.
Roosevelt, right?
I wasn't alive then. How the hell?
Choose again.
I wasn't alive either, but he started the whole park system, didn't he?
It's at his feast that Daniel interprets the writing on the wall. Player one?
Oh no.
Yes. Player one.
Very emotional roller coaster there.
The star on Nevada's flag is this metallic color because it represents Nevada's state mineral.
Yeah.
It's player one. Right. You get to pick again, player one. This Peanuts character got a sister named Sally in 1959. Player two.
Snoopy. Oh, he was Charlie Brown's sister, wasn't
he? Anyone else?
I wasn't paying attention.
Let's hear it, player one.
Snoopy's sister. That's right.
I didn't pick
you Snoopy. Again, player one. Weirdo would be another name for this Dan Ferraro comic that began as a replacement for The Far Side. Okay, player one. Player one, pick again. Mr. Munster wasn't the subject of this 1975 to 1992 Jim Unger script. It's player two.
Good. Good.
Select again. He traveled with Paul to spread Jesus' teachings until they disagreed and separated. Yes, player one. Anyone else care to try to come up with the correct response?
Bart.
It's player two.
Well, Paul and Bart.
That's correct. Player two, back to you. The youngest son of Jacob and Rachel. Okay, player two. Yes.
Yes.
Please pick again. Player two. The chief god of the Canaanites. Player two. That's correct. Choose again. Player two. Her first husband was the Hittite Uriah. David was second. Yes, player two.
Bethany.
You're right. Select again.
On the roof.
In Bob Fave's comic, Frank bums around with this guy.
Bums around. People
Let's
don't
hear
say
it,
that anymore,
one.
They try not to.
Sorry, that's wrong.
Who's not?
Any I don't know, takers? But I heard Grandma talk about
it. Frank and
okay,
Matt.
Player two.
No, what? Oh, Frank and... Oh...
No.
Who's Dilbert?
Anyone else?
Well, Dilbert, I know what the strip Dilbert is. I've never heard of it.
Mutt and Jeff is who I was thinking of because Grandma talked about
You get to pick again, player.
Who knows?
To completely reverse your direction while driving is to pull a, one of these.
Grandpa.
Player one?
Yeah. Well, where's my thing?
Fast
one. Right. Please pick again, player one. A popular koan, or meditation subject of Zen Buddhism, asks the student to try to imagine this sound.
A really loud cow.
It's player two. Player three.
Imagine the sound of a tree falling.
Player two, back to you for our next selection. Numerical name for Scheherazade's tales. Let's hear it, player two. Good for you. You again, player two. Title of playwright Moss Hart's autobiography.
Who's Moss Hart?
Yeah, I have no idea.
Here's the response we were looking for. Act one. Player two, you pick again, please.
Oh, no.
I thought it was act two.
One of the daily double. You are currently in the lead. Please enter your way. All right, here's your clue. The U.S. merchant ship Mayaguez was seized by Cambodian forces. U.S. forces rescued the crew of 39.
This?
What's the question?
Oh,
yeah.
Jeez.
Okay.
sounds like a real Nixon thing to happen.
You are still in first place, though. We're talking about Gerald Ford.
Like the car.
The one that fell over.
Pick again. The Telstar communications satellite relayed the first live TV pictures from the United States to Europe. Yes, player one. That is correct. Player one, back to you. The sheaf of this grain symbolizes what else? Agriculture. On Ohio State Seal. Okay, player two.
To be great.
That is correct.
You don't really have a sheaf of anything else.
We return to you, player two.
No.
This edgy Aaron Magruder comic strip debuted in 1996. Player one.
I love that.
Good.
Good.
You get to pick again, player one. Here's Kelly, she'll show you.
In the 21st century, International Morse Code added its first new character in decades. It combines A and C to symbolize this sign.
Let's hear it, player two.
Yeah.
Sorry. Any other takers?
Go for the 50-50.
Here's the correct response.
Pound.
The apt sign.
There you go.
You again, player one. Mm-hmm. Not the Easter, but the prairie type of this flower is the floral emblem of Saskatchewan.
Easter.
It's player one.
My facial expression.
Player one, back to you.
Now you've done it.
The second daily double.
You're 8:32 behind me.
How much? Answer this. From the Latin for triple leaf, it's the name of the official Girl Scout emblem.
I think that's right.
That's right. Way to go.
Damn it.
Choose again, player one.
I should have been more. No.
Based in Chicago, this financial services provider merged with JP Morgan Chase in 2004.
I don't know.
I should know this. I looked at it online, but I can't do that.
Here's the correct response.
You can't look
Bank
that.
One.
This is Bank One.
Select again.
President.
The Alien and Sedition Acts were adopted by Congress.
I really like having that one here.
The Alien Acts.
The correct response is John Adams.
Here you go, Ma.
We return to you, player
okay,
one.
Okay, Joe. Let's let you loose.
It's the quantity x represents in the logarithmic equation log 10x equals 2. Okay, player 2.
This is just stupid.
You are correct. Player 2, pick again. Newton and Leibniz share credit for developing the fundamental theorem of this branch of mathematics. It's player two.
Dumbass.
That's it.
Yeah. Who, me or
back to you,
Newton?
The order of operations is irrelevant according to this property of both addition and multiplication. Player two.
Okay, wait, hang on. I don't get what they mean by this. Commutative? It doesn't make any sense how they worded it. Commutative says that you can switch
the order. Yeah, but the order of operations. corporations is irrelevant.
Here is the response we were looking for. The associate.
You don't even know what they're talking about.
Oh, but I could figure it out.
You pick again. No arguing with Euclid's fourth postulate. All right angles are this, meaning of equal measure in degrees. Mm. Yes, player two.
Congruent.
Right you are.
Well,
and we'll wrap up the board with this
one. Congruent
is the first number in this simple operation. Let's hear it, player two.
Munad.
Let's see, munad?
That is correct.
It's minimum.
All three of you will participate.
What's a munad? Right, it sounds like a gonad.
I have no idea.
Point to the color closest to that of the Mona Lisa's dress.
I can't remember.
No.
Player two, roll the winner and crowd favorite for this minigame. Look in the menu to view.
Oh, look at that prize. Don't you want that?
You got the Alex Trebek concept. Sounds like a band.
We've got the final Jeopardy round here for you, and today it features this category. 16th century names. So, what's your wager?
Okay.
Each direction on the plus control pad represents a different response.
Yes, we get
press
that.
A direction to select an answer. The final Jeopardy clue is, Paul III roared at him, I have waited 30 years for your services. Now I'm Pope, can't I satisfy my desire?
What? I don't.
What did you say?
What'd you say?
And that correct response.
Well, there you go.
Well, I guess you can, yeah.
And
you're still going to win, though. It doesn't matter.
Sorry, that incorrect response will drop your score by...
and yours by $433.
He was the guy, right?
No.
Martin Luther.
Congratulations, player two.
He disagreed with the Pope,
really
wasn't he?
That
was his whole...
Thanks for playing. We'll see you next time.
I don't know.
He didn't like
me. I'm not Catholic. I'm not religious. How would I know?
Oh, it's a good interview.
You know what? Some tennis right now, so bad.
I bet you could.